Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to fix error compiling movie, which is something that happens to me when I'm trying to render a video, not so much on the export, but the render before the export. So I'm going to show you a couple ways to fix this. All right, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing to try is changing your project settings. Now, if you have a newer Mac with an M1 chip, this might not work for you. So there'll be another solution for you a little later. Okay, so let's go ahead and try with the project settings. We'll go to File, Project Settings, and General. And then here under Renderer, change this to Mercury Playback Engine Software Only. Then we'll say okay, and then we'll save the project. And then finally, close Premiere Pro and restart it. And now I'll make sure my endpoint and outpoint are set. So to do this, I can hit the home button on my keyboard, and then I'll hit the letter I for in. Then I'll hit end on my keyboard, the end button, and hit O for out. So now the entire movie is included. Then I'll come up here and go to sequence, render into out. Now this will take some time, of course, but hopefully it'll pass this stage now. All right, so this worked for me. Now I'm going to go ahead and export my video. So I'll go to File, Export Media. And then we'll want to click on Video here. Next, scroll down and choose More. Then under Encoding Settings and Performance, choose Software Encoding instead. And then go ahead and export it. Now that should fix the problem if you have an older machine. Now I'm on my other Mac, which is a more recent version. It does have the M1 chip, so I don't have access to that area in Project Settings. So if I come up here to File, Project Settings in general, you can see it's grayed out right here. So if that's the case, go ahead and look at the error message that you got. Sometimes it'll say when the render failed, and you should be looking at two parts. There'll be something that says around time code and rendering at offset. So if you have a clip right at that timestamp, let's say it's around 2 minutes in, then you can try deleting that and then re-importing it and then trying the render again. Another thing is to try to change your in and out and render the stuff before it. So let's say it's this clip that's causing the issue. So I'm going to move just to the left of that and then change my out to right here and then render this. So we can do sequence render into out, which has already been done, so it's working fine. And then you can set your in and out and render everything after that clip. And then finally, render just that clip. So you would go in and out like this and render that. Now, when I render everything separately like that, it actually fixes the problem like 8 out of 10 times. So once you've done that, go ahead and render the entire thing again and see if you're still getting the error. Now, if your error message is like mine and it just says unknown error, I have to troubleshoot this a different way. And the way I do that to find the little piece that's causing the problem is I'll pick an out point right about here, and the end point can be at the beginning. I'll render this, and if I'm still getting that error, it's somewhere in here. And then I can kind of just narrow that down by rendering just this part and figuring it out that way where that piece is. And then either deleting it and re-importing it or doing the multiple renders and seeing if that takes care of it. So for me, the issue was this part right here. I've already rendered everything that you see with the green bar here. So I'm going to just choose this little piece and render that. And that still didn't work. So I'm going to just select these, delete them, and paste them on again and see if that fixes it. I'll go to sequence render into out. And that did it. Just cutting and pasting these two pieces, which are this little section header, fix the problem. And now my video works the way it should. If you're still having trouble, please leave a comment in the comment section below. And then either me or somebody in our little YouTube community can help figure out a solution. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.